Tonight, former New York City Mayor Mike Bloomberg not ruling out spilling $1 billion on this election cycle, either to win the presidency himself or ensure Donald Trump's defeat. This is according to the New York Times. Now, Bloomberg has already spent $200 million on advertising. It's only been 2 months. And President Trump is taking notice, tweeting on the latest Bloomberg ad, quote, "Mini Mike Bloomberg is spending a lot of money on false advertising." Out front now, Kevin Sheekey, campaign manager for the Bloomberg campaign and long-term political strategist at Bloomberg. You have known him for decades. So President Trump is now calling Mayor Bloomberg Mini Mike, a famous nickname that he has used before. Obviously, it shows this is getting under his skin that he chose to respond today. Is that what you want to hear?
Yeah, listen, I mean, I think Trump is, wants to be everything that Mike is, right? He wants to be a real leader. He wants to be someone who's actually delivered on healthcare that Mike has. He wants to be someone who's actually created a real business. He wants to be a real billionaire. Mike has led the city in ways that brought people together, and Trump tears people apart. I mean, Mike Bloomberg in many ways is the antithesis of everything that Trump tries to pretend that he is.
So Bloomberg's strategy has a lot of people obsessed, okay, what he's doing. He argues in an op-ed today on CNN, the primary process is undemocratic and political harmful to the nominee. His argument, the Democratic Party reflects America's incredible diversity, but the first two voting states, Iowa and New Hampshire, are among the most homogenous in the nation. The problem is compounded by the fact that the two early voting states are unlikely to be consequential in the general election, which is a fair point, except for he also said this about the nominee process just 5 days ago. Kevin, here he is.
I think we've got a tradition here of four states, two with caucuses, two with elections. They've worked very hard. They love the attention. The system has gotten used to it. And I guess the Democratic Party probably shouldn't take it away.
How can you think both those things at the same time? Let it stay the way it is, and it's inconsequential and not the right thing.
Well, there's a little bit that's cut off. I was there. We were up in Akron, Ohio, and the part that got cut off is that the rules don't really make any sense. And Mike thought about it, and he wrote an op-ed, which he submitted to you here at CNN, to say, hey, these don't make any sense. I think the big issue, which is missing for a lot of people, is that Donald Trump today is winning this election. And it's a really hard thing to hear. It's a tougher thing to believe. But a general election is only fought in six states. It's fought in this year. It used to be 10 or 14. This year, it'll be six. It's Wisconsin, Pennsylvania, Michigan, North Carolina, Florida, and Arizona. That's it. Those are the competitive states. Mm-hmm. Democrats have spent a year, my party, investing in the state of Iowa, knocking on every door, seeing every available Democrat. 99 counties, raising every nickel we can from every Democratic donor around the country and investing in Iowa. Democrat, Republican pollsters agree on one thing. Donald Trump's going to win Iowa this year. So we've spent a year and every nickel we can raise on a state that we're going to lose. And what Mike has said is, hey, listen, if I was president of the United States and had the honor of running the Democratic Party, I would change that. And the first state would be Wisconsin. The second state would be Michigan. The third would be Pennsylvania. And the fourth would be North Carolina. Imagine what would be happening now if CNN was headed to Wisconsin tomorrow. The host of the debate.
Completely different conversation.
Totally different conversation. And we would, as Democrats, be on the road to winning Wisconsin. Whereas right now we're on the road to lose a state that Donald Trump won by a mere 23,000 votes in the last election.
And he'll be there tomorrow night when the Democrats are in Iowa.
And he'll be there tomorrow. And he's stronger now than he was the day he won.
Okay, so Bloomberg has not ruled out spending $1 billion. It's a lot of money by any stretch of the imagination. However, I think relative comparisons always matter. That's 1.7% of his net worth, according to Forbes. Just so people know, that's $58.4 billion by their running total. Is there a limit on what he's willing to spend? I know, he stayed out of this for a while. You guys did the math. You felt that there was a return on that investment that you could get. Is there a limit?
Yeah, listen, I think Mike didn't use the term $1 billion. The New York Times said, would you spend $1 billion? And Mike didn't answer in the positive or negative, and that's the headline that they wrote. Mike has spent an awful amount of money on this election so far. And what he has said with great clarity is, I will spend whatever it takes to remove Donald Trump from office. He has said, I didn't want to sit on the sidelines. I got in this campaign because I think I have a role to play. And I think if I'm the nominee, I can put together the most diverse, the strongest campaign to defeat the president. And if I'm not the nominee, then I will support whoever the nominee is with my money to make sure that we can fight in those battleground states I mentioned.
And just to be clear, if President Trump spent that amount of money, which he wouldn't because he's going to use other people's money, donors and RNC, it would be a third of his fortune, according to Forbes. Versus 1.7%. Thank you very much.